since it's culture, we're all going to sing. Girls RC will now lead us in the school prayer. Okay, begin.
Praise to you, Almighty God, creator of the universe and all that is in it. We thank you, Father, for the opportunity which you have given us to increase our knowledge. May your divine grace enable us to study hard and use what we learn for the good of our fellow citizens. We pray that you will free us from selfishness, lust, greed, anger, and hatred. Warm our hearts with love, fill our minds with understanding, and strengthen our wills in the face of all difficulties. Help us, O Father, to make our beloved country of Trinidad and Tobago the kind of place you want it to be, a place where human dignity is respected, where equal rights are accorded to all citizens, where hard work is encouraged and rewarded, and where you, O God, reign supreme. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
May I have your seats? I'll now hand you over to the Master of Ceremonies for today, Mr. Franklin Phillip. He will take you through the proceedings.
Good morning to all present, and welcome to another day of competition at the festival. This is a seems to be a quiet day since we were full of activities over the last 2 days.
This one is yours.
Our judges this morning are who is a representative of the NGC, and Mrs. Linda Belmontes, retired school teacher principal. Can I hear a round of applause to the judges, please? We have 2 schools registered so far. But before we get into the first school, I just want to remind you that you should turn your cell phone off, or to put it on some mode that it will not interrupt the performance. If you have to leave the auditorium, please do so now, unless you have an emergency later on. And there should be no leaving or entering the auditorium while the performance is in progress. The washrooms are located through that door. Ladies go to the left, the gents go to the right. So first on stage, this morning, in class 14 for skits, the Marabella South Secondary School. And they are going to do a skit entitled Zika. Put your hands together for Marabella South Secondary.
Mosquitoes in your house, yeah.
sip me, shake me. Me no want no mosquito sting me. Me no know if it's a sign from the Almighty or a scientist I use them brain power. Zip me, shake me. Me no want no mosquito sting me. Me no know if it's a sign from the.
What's all going on?
Come on, I'm a stink attack!
Shall we write in the stink attack?
Sure, I don't walk. Stink attack,
high and fine. You are your husband nasty same way, I don't want to clean all day.
Your Honor, sorry, this is the
been sworn in. Your Honor, this is a case between Mr. and Mrs. Tinkerton and Mr. Cole. You all may be seated.
Miss Marco, I see here.
What, Your Honor?
Woman, get out of my court. Get out!
What is going on, Miss Marple?
As I was saying, Miss Marco, I see here that you are suing Mr. and Mrs. Tinkerton for the apparent disability of your son, Michael. You are contending that because of their surroundings, there was an increase in mosquitoes, thereby causing your son to be born with the Stinkertons, on the other hand, is countersuing for harassment. First, I'll hear from Mrs. Marco.
Your Honor, for the past 9 months, we the residents of Snake Avenue have been begging these two here to clean up their yard.
How did that affect the residents if it is in their yard?
Well, Your Honor, water gathers in old tires and bottles, making it the perfect breeding space for mosquitoes.
Mosquitoes just bring sentiment.
Damn nasty.
Explain what this has to do with your case, ma'am.
Well, Your Honor, I distinctly remember on January 5th this year, I was bitten by mosquitoes coming from the Stinkerton's yard. And these insects bit me at least once a day for the past 9 months.
Well, Miss Marco, I do not see your case. Why are you suing these people?
Well, Your Honor, I had a baby 2 weeks ago, and well, he was born with a Zika disease.
You mean microcephaly?
Something like that. All I know is the Stinkerton's responsible for my baby looking so, and I want compensation.
Not so fast. I want to hear from the Stinkerton's. I think that has anything to do with the case. Please stick to the subject.
Yes, Your Honor. Well, I work from 9 to 6, and sometimes in the evening I don't have time to cook supper from KFC on Royal Castle. Well, yes, sometimes we leave the food outside, and we can take it, so sometimes we throw it away. And the tires, I just don't have time to cut it out to put around the plants.
So you are admitting your family was responsible for the mosquitoes in the area?
Your Honor, the mosquitoes are in the whole village. Nobody knows that the mosquitoes come from by me.
It's from by you, said the snake, and not you yourself.
You read the one to tell you who snake?
Yes.
Order. Women, please control yourselves. So you don't think you are responsible for this woman's distress?
Your Honor, Mrs. Marco is taking a mountain of a moral health. I am not under hospital. I have seen the baby. His heart is small, but not so small than any other baby. His eyes are a bit big, but he's just a baby. She should look for a father.
Please continue. This is all part of the case.
I am just saying, Your Honor, that sometimes you must learn to listen to what people have to say.
So why did you speak to my husband?
Oh, honey, every time you go to work and don't have the time to listen, you'd be surprised.
Who wants you with a small head and a big eye?
Well, it is clear that the mosquitoes came from the Stinkertons. The court will award Ms. Mako the sum she is asking for, $5,000. Still, we number. That was the Marbella South Secondary School. I want to ask the students to please come in the audience as soon as you are finished. I am certain that the judges will have something to say to you. So while we await the Marbella students and we give the judges some time to get their thoughts together, we invite the St. Gabriel's Girls RC School to set up their props, if they have any, on stage. Let us welcome St. Gabriel's Girls RC as they do for us, Bring Back My Sunshine.
To shine, and the moon lost its brightness. Everything became chaos. Darkness overtook the land, and the once bright, beautiful place was no longer bright and beautiful. Suddenly, a light shone. and moon, sun, stars, and clouds saw themselves being transformed into humans. Everything felt different. Okay.
Together.
destroyed. She confronts new stranger.
So you followed me here.
You noticed?
I will not allow you to do this again.
Do what?
Destroy and kill all that is good.
How are you going to stop me?
Fight for a worthy cause.
And so the both strangers fought with each other, while the humans continued to fight and argue. Before long, the stranger was on the ground. She had lost the fight, or so they thought. They took her up and carried her away. As they did so, they began to transform back into their original beings. They felt lighter and realized they were returning to the universe. They were filled with joy. And the stranger, she was left alone on the earth. She had destroyed her only source. She remained there and soon formed part of the earth. Meanwhile, the universe rejoiced that things had returned to normalcy because one being fought to save them.
Just saw from the St. Gabriel's Girls RC School, Bring Back My Sunshine. Let's give them a nice round of applause again, please. Students of Marbella, to come a little closer, please, so that when the judges have their comments to make, they can speak to you directly. Thank you very, very much for cooperating. I am certain that you are going to be given some guidelines on how to improve, and these guidelines are going to be given whether you move forward or not. The first two schools in each district move forward. Now we only have one school, you are the only school. But that does not necessarily mean that you will move forward. Once you make the required mark, you are going to move forward. But since SANFEST is about development, we are going to give you guidelines so that it will assist you in the future. But I hope for your sake that the judges have seen sufficient to send you forward, okay? So please listen attentively to what they have to say concerning your performance. Mr. Bramble, I think I have noticed a slight error in the drama finals. If you look at the book, you would see the primary schools on the 4th, and I suspect the secondary schools are also on the 4th, but the column there, it fell on the Monday the 7th. They forgot to extend the line. All right, so we'll have to make that clear, because the 9 a.m. on the 4th and the 1 p.m. suggests to me that the primary schools will come in the morning and the secondary schools will come in the afternoon. Fine? Fair enough? Yes. Okay, good, right. So we just have to make sure that schools do not feel that the secondary schools will come on Monday the 7th at 1 p.m. Okay? Right, so where is St. Gabriel's? We're just waiting on St. Gabriel's to come downstairs. In the meantime, just for your information, so we are completing the preliminary round of the competition. And tomorrow we'll have dance ITF for primary and secondary schools. And that will also continue on Monday. On Monday also we have the competition. On Monday we go to the Southeastern District. On Tuesday we go to Port of Spain. On Wednesday we are back here in Victoria. On Thursday we go to St. Patrick. And on Friday, Northeastern and Caroni District. And then the finals will begin on the 18th of October in the visual arts, 18th and 19th. 18th, 19th, and 20th. And the 21st for visual arts. Music finals begin. Finals begin on the 24th. Dance finals begin on the 28th. And the drama finals, as I said before, that begins on the 4th. The command performances are on the 22nd of November and the 23rd of November. For primary schools on the 23rd, 22nd, and secondary schools on the 23rd. So just give us a few more minutes as we await St. Gabriel's as they change back into their uniforms and the judges will address us.
Pleasant morning to one and all. And before I give the comments, I want you to give yourselves a round of applause, seeing that you are the only. Thank you very much. Seeing that I know each year as I judge here, I know that we can count on Marabella to be present. And this morning, as you saw, we had just one primary and one secondary school entered. And this, you know, I am a person very much in love with drama. And it pains me to see that in the Victoria Education Division that schools are not taking on drama as one of their priorities, main concerns. So I want to applaud those of you here this morning who were trained and came here to show us your dramatic skills. We always like to begin with the positive comments first. Marabella, choice of topic, very good, since we know what Zika is all about. And all over the world, it's a global concern for the environment. So we thought that the topic was well chosen. However, we thought that a little more could have been done with it to project that message across to us. The use of the audio effect at the beginning, I think the song, as far as we were able to hear, was in keeping with the theme Zika. One or two pointers that we need to give you in order to make your presentation better. This is what we call constructive criticism. It's not criticism to make you feel bad, but it's to make you better. And we were well aware that you didn't know your lines. We knew that you were reading your lines from behind the folders. So we know that sometimes you don't have enough time, but if we send you on, you know that's a no-no. You have to know your lines. When you are performing, remember you have an audience. And yes, you are talking to the person on stage, but try to avoid giving your back to the audience. We had one or two instances when you had to walk across the stage and it was as if you were speaking to the curtain and not to your audience. So yes, you have to walk and you're walking quickly and you want to get whatever you're saying across, but remember that you project your voice, you're walking, yes, but turn to the audience to do so when you have to speak.
If you forget, some people who are not reading the lines, you forget on stage. Sometimes we, the judges, we are not following word by word what you have to say. Don't let it be obvious that you forget something. That's where you could improvise. And sometimes the way you do it very tactfully, the audience is not aware that you have forgotten something. Slow down. Slow down. I know we are living in an instant world, instant everything, but we need to slow down when we are on stage. And I think it was, is it Miss Maku? Is it Maku or Mako? I don't know what you wanted it pronounced as, but I know it's M-A-C-O-U. Try, even though you want to be heard and you know you're getting annoyed and so with your husband, but try to avoid over-shouting. We thought that there was a missing link between the first scene and the court scene. We were wondering, and I know that we were able to understand where it was coming from when you started at the second scene, but there must be a link. We should have heard the neighbors, the ones who were complaining about the place being so, you know, badly littered and so on. We should have heard that a decision has taken place, that you meet or something like that, and that you have decided this is going too far. Zika is a virus that causes great concern. We are going to take these untidy neighbors to court. So that link. I think that's about it from what I'm seeing in my notes. Now, what we the judges have decided here to do is that since you are the only schools entered, that we will send you on, but with a lot of fixing up, as I would like to say. You know, taking the comments into consideration, knowing your lines, getting that missing link, and, you know, just making it a better presentation. But we want to commend you for being the only school to be here this morning, and because of this, we will be allowing you to go on. But when you reach that final stage, you are in for heavy, heavy competition. So that you must improve your performance. So much for Maribella. St. Gabriel's. Again, choice of topic good. Again, it's one of environmental concern. But we thought that it could have been given a little more meat, for want of a better word, to bring that message across. I know sometimes you have such a short time to prepare when school reopens and to be present here. But, you know, sometimes you need to put a little more into the presentation. The narrator, we thought, very good. We heard every word, good pronunciation and everything else, and she helped the performance to flow. So because you had the narrator, you got the cue as to when you should come in and what you should see. But again, try to avoid, we were seeing you and we were hearing you telling the person, say this now, say that now, you know? Because you think, well, we don't see that or hear that, but we do. So just, even with the eye, you could make a little thing to them, but try to avoid telling them, say it, or come now. The aliens, good, you know, especially when you had to be in that particular position on stage, as we say in drama, freezing on stage. But we thought that overall, well, I know again for probably the time that you had to prepare, costuming will enhance the presentations a lot. The moon, the sun, the aliens, they really look like aliens and so on. So the costuming. Again, in one instance there, you gave us your back. Try to avoid giving your back to the audience. The audience must be part and parcel of what is being done. Again, we said positive message, narrator, very good. So give yourselves a lusty round of applause. Thank you very much.
That's from Mrs. Belmontez for what I think, yes. And just in case people did not gather all that she said, I was thinking of some notes. So Marabella, and you need to work on what Mrs. Belmontez said, because you are given, as young people would say, a blay, because you are the only school, okay? And we want to commend you for that. But we know, she knows, the judges know, and we know that the competition is going to be a little keener as you go forward. So please take what has been said, and I will give you a gentle reminder again. She said that your choice of topic was good, excellent. Okay, it's topical, Zika, so we have no problem there. And you would have gained a very good mark if there was choice of topic on the judging criteria. But she said more could have been done with the topic, so you need to beef it up a little bit. Judges, if I'm going wrong, you could always, Miss Buriram, you could tell me if I'm going wrong. You could beef it up a little bit, right? So you have to try and put something a little more into the topic to make it, to drive the point home. She spoke about reading lines, so we know, okay, probably you weren't ready. But you know what? We didn't start in Victoria first, as we have done in previous years. So, okay, so we see, we thought that Victoria will be very ready. But, be that as it may, we are saying that we excuse you now for your lines, but we hope that by the time you get to the next rounds, you will not be reading from the folders and so on, right? Don't turn your back to the audience, because you are performing and the people in the audience need to hear what you are saying. So whatever you do, whatever you say, whenever you are speaking, ensure that you are projecting your voice so that the judges and the people in the audience can hear you. If you forget your lines, don't make it obvious. Okay? The judges have the sheets in front of them, but we don't expect you to follow it, or everyone to follow it word for word. So that could happen. But you have to be smart and be quick and to fill in. Okay? Don't let it be obvious. Slow down, and I could relate to that. The young lady in front here who was talking very, very fast, probably a little nervousness too, and so on. Slow down a bit, because we need to hear what you are saying. Okay? Slow down. And I could also identify with what Mrs. Belmonte said here. There was a little missing link. In other words, you need to join the first scene a little better with the second scene. So something was missing there. All right, and as I said before, we commend you for your participation, and we wish you success as you go forward. I expect you to go forward, so we wish you some success. All the success, I should say. And St. Gabriel's, again, the judges thought that your topic was, choice of topic was good. But again, she's saying you need to do a little more with the topic. Beef it up a little more. Give it something extra to bring across your point. All right? To make your presentation a little more effective. Narrator was good, yes. The narrator was clear, the voice was clear. You could have heard everything that the narrator said, and pronunciation was good, and so on. If you have to give information from the side of the stage, which is something that I have seen common, ensure that your voice is not heard. You have to be careful that the voice, the people in the audience could hear your voice, and the judges. We have to be aware of that. Costuming, she said, will enhance the performance. You had the aliens. It doesn't take much. You know what to do. If you do that, you will add to the entire production. And again, don't turn your back to the audience. Whenever you have to speak, you have to be conscious of the fact that you are speaking to your audience. And more specifically, to the judges. So give yourselves a nice round of applause. And thanks to Mrs. Boudram and Mrs. Belmontes. It is now 11 o'clock and schools were supposed to report here at 9. We suspect at this point, but we won't leave, we suspect at this point that no more schools will turn up for the day. So please get back to your schools safely and continue practicing. Thank you very much.